Hey guys, in this video I want to discuss how we can create a double bounce work cycle animation in After Effects. Okay, so what I want to do is to create this double work cycle by just editing the regular work cycle that I had made in the previous videos. So if you're still unfamiliar with rigging characters, you can watch this video where I talked about it in great detail. And if you're unfamiliar with creating a work cycle, you can watch this one. Alright, let's get right into it. Okay, so the first thing that you need to know about creating a double work cycle is that the double work cycle is relatively slower than the regular work cycle. So logically, it needs more time. If you remember, the length of the regular work cycle was only 1 second. Or 24 frames, but for the double work cycle we need 32 frames. So I trim the work area right here. I hide the background layers. I also shy every other layer except for the controllers that I will be needing. Okay, so when the walk cycle lasts for 32 frames, the gap between poses should be just 4 frames. Alright, the next thing that I have to do is move the keyframes to the work area and place the first keyframes at the beginning of the timeline. The keyframes of the left arm, this is fine. And the controllers of the left leg, this is alright. I move the keyframes of the body rotation here. So these keyframes should be placed at the last contact pose. These keyframes should be moved where the second contact pose is, and these for the first contact pose. I also select these keyframes, and by holding Alt and dragging, I increase the distance between the keyframes and place them where the new poses are. Okay, after doing that, I move the controllers of the left arm back right here, so it would be the opposite of the right arm. Then I select both layers and move them back, so the final keyframes of the left arm would be at the start of the timeline. So the animation of the arms would be looped at 32 frames. Then I move the left leg controllers back so they would be the opposite of the right leg. And finally, I delete the keyframes of the head and the body all together and disable their expressions. And since I won't be needing the X position, I hold Ctrl Shift Alt and I click on the X position so it would remain hidden. Now let's play and see how it turned out. As you see, the walk cycle is looping correctly and it slowed a bit. Well, as you understood, the most important thing about the double walk cycle is that the number of up and down movements of the body is twice as the regular walk cycle. To make it simple, isolate the body controller and double click on its marker. In the contact, the body of the character should be placed lower, so I type down here. In the down pose, the body should be upper. I make a marker here and type up in here. In the next pose, which is the pass pose, again the body should be placed lower. Here up. Here again down. I continue like this until the end so it would be obvious where the body will be in each position. Well, before starting the work, I place a ruler right here and mark where the ground is. Now, it's time to animate the body part, which is the most important part of the character, and other parts move relative to the body. So I start from the down pose, because the body part should be upper. And once we understand how much the body should go up, it's not hard to adjust how much the body goes down. So I move it up and pay attention that the foot of your character doesn't lift off from the ground as you move the body. And at the same time, the leg shouldn't be bent. It should be completely straight. I create a keyframe for it. I head to the first contact pose. I lower the body part. I think this should be enough. The body moves up and then in the pass pose, it moves lower. But here I lower it down more than where it was in the contact pose. Let me make the body controllers visible. As you can see, this is the keyframes of the contact pose. So in this pose, the body of the character should be lower. Here I copy this keyframe. And in the contact pose, I paste the first contact keyframe. And then I copy these three keyframes and paste them over here. Because from the second contact pose, the keyframes won't change and they'll repeat. Well, I select the keyframes and make them ease. Let's see how it turned out. Okay, so far so good. To make it even better, in the contact pose, the legs shouldn't be bent. So I select the right leg controller and let me make it visible and make it straight. But not too straight, maybe just a little bit bent. And I leave it like this. And in the second contact pose, I make this leg slightly straight. And in the last contact pose, I just copy and paste the first contact keyframes. After I'm done with it, since the character is in side view, I can use the right leg keyframes for the left leg as well. I copy the keyframes and head over to the start of the timeline. I select the left leg and I hit Ctrl V. Then I move the layer backward so the legs are opposite each other. Let's see how it looks. It's so much better now. Now it's time to animate the rotation of the body. I create a keyframe for it here. In the contact pose, the body should be rotated back. I think -3 should be good. And in the pass pose, it should move forward. I think 2 should be good. I copy the keyframes and paste them here. And for the last contact, I copy and paste the first contact keyframes and make them easy ease. Let's check it out. It looks good to me. Now let's work on the animation of the head. I create a keyframe for it here. In the contact pose, the body of the character is backward. I also rotate the head backward and set it to -7. Then in the pass pose, I set it to 0. I copy and paste these keyframes here too. And make them easy ease. The rotation of the head should be delayed relative to the rotation of the body. To do that and not to ruin the loop, first of all, I enable these expressions. Since the rotation of the head should be delayed a little bit, I move these keyframes forward. But since I use the loop out expression for looping the keyframes, and this expression works after the keyframes, it's not work in these two frames. So it's better to select the keyframes and place the last contact keyframes for the second contact pose, and then move two frames forward for making the delay I'm aiming for. Well, I think the movement of the head is not good. I head over to its second keyframe, which is set to 0. And I set it to 2, so the head would rotate forward just a little bit. I do the same for this keyframe as well. And then I make it overlap. Let's see how it turned out. It looks much better. Now let's work on the other layers. I also changed the animation of the shadow. I make it longer. I make the background layer visible. I also modified the animation of the shoelace. It looks great. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like this video and consider subscribing if you like more of these videos. And if you're interested in making animations and motion graphics in After Effects, and you're still at the beginning of learning and you want to have a smooth path to becoming a pro motion designer, I recommend you to enroll in Motion Hero course. Because in this masterclass, I talked about all the necessary topics that a pro motion designer needs with lots of practice and projects. So you have the fastest path toward perfection, and you wouldn't have to do the same mistakes as I did. So enroll now and take your skills to the next level.